talking about why humans commit suicide. So a little bit of background. Suicide is one of the leading causes of death in the developed world. In third world countries, it's not nearly as prevalent. I thought that was pretty interesting. An average of 113 people commit suicide every day in the United States. So psychological and sociological aspects. So the reason a lot of people commit suicide, according to psychologists, is depression. And that is just a mood disturbance characterized by extreme sadness and despair. And there's a couple of different symptoms of it. So the first is emotional, and that would be like the actual sadness you feel. The next is motivational, and that's like you have no ability to do anything anymore. Then cognitive, and that's just the way you see yourself. A lot of people with depression see themselves really terribly. And somatic, and that's like the actual biological effects, like loss of energy, stuff like that. And so Kimberly Van Orden did an experiment called the interpersonal theory of suicide. And so she found that 95% of people that commit suicide have a mental disorder, whether it be just depression, schizophrenia, from slight causes to like pretty serious mental disorders. And she also found that depression has increased a lot since the beginning of the 20th century. And she's seen that there's been a shift in the workplace. So in the beginning of the 20th century, a lot of jobs were outside, 38%. People like worked on farms and stuff, but now only 3 do. So she thinks that can be attributed to it. And lack of exercise. Even homemakers 50 years ago still had to clean by hand, stuff like that, wash dishes by hand. Now we have like Swiffers, vacuums, dishwashers, so people just aren't exercising nearly as much as they used to. So some biological aspects. In an article by the Department of Psychology at McMaster University called Human Suicide, A Biological Perspective, they studied 4 biological mechanisms that dealt with suicide. So the first one they looked at was they thought that suicide evolved independently from biological evolution. So basically it's a learned behavior. There's a psychologist named B.F. Skinner that he thought suicide can be genetic, because if it was, then anyone that had it would be dead really quickly because it's a genetic thing. And they also argued that the way a lot of people commit suicide is through advances in technology. So like guns, jumping off tall buildings, drugs. None of that's really inane to us. The next mechanism was suicide as pathology. And so that kind of focuses on our genes. So like some people have bad genes for stress, say. So the people that have bad genes for stress are gonna commit suicide. And another mechanism they did was an altruistic mechanism. And altruism is basically sacrificing yourself for the good of the group. So a reason for some suicides, but not all, could be that you're sacrificing yourself for everybody else. And then evolutionary tolerance. And that's kind of the same thing as pathology, but like it examines your genes and your situation to determine how likely you are to commit suicide. And so people that are in bad relationships usually have a much greater chance of committing suicide. People that have bad genes to deal with stress have a lot greater chance of committing suicide. And conclusion. So if we can kind of intertwine biological and psychological together, we can find a way to like treat psychological aspects, because we don't know why a lot of people have depression. It might be a cause from the brain, like not enough vitamins, whatever. So if we can find a reason, a biological reason, why people are suffering, a psychological reason, then maybe we can find a way to treat suicide.